Thank you, Alex, and good morning, everyone. My name is Jeff Hoffman, and I lead product management for the pharmacy and healthcare businesses at Walgreens. Walgreens is pursuing an exciting transformation in our business where we're modernizing and reinventing our customer and colleague experiences. It's a pleasure to be with you today to talk specifically about our journey to become a data-driven enterprise. For those of you unfamiliar with Walgreens, we operate 8,500 stores throughout the United States and Puerto Rico with 220,000 team members serving our approximately 9 million customers each day. We have a heritage of almost 125 years caring for communities and providing the best quality care to our patients. As a result, Walgreens and our pharmacists play an ever-increasing role within the healthcare ecosystem. Today, I would like to double-click into the dynamics and opportunities that we have been focusing on within our pharmacy business specifically. At its core, Walgreens is a platform business with clinical and commercial offerings that service a wide range of patients and B2B partners. What that means is that we participate in a large, complicated, integrated, and interrelated pharmacy and healthcare ecosystem. Within Walgreens itself, we have our own complex ecosystem. We operate a broad network of stores. We run 11 pharmacies that in the country that fill prescriptions using robotics and automation. We have hundreds of colleagues who perform tasks remotely on behalf of our stores, and we have multiple customer journeys and multiple engagement channels. Having that reach and scale means that we are collecting billions of data points every day. However, having that reach and scale also means that we have billions of data points every day to disposition. And what has happened over time is that our data resides in disparate and disconnected systems, and it makes it challenging to manage, let alone continually assess and adjust our decision rubrics. Considering the state of our data estate, we often find ourselves implementing rules-based decisions that typically target only an individual component of the pharmacy value stream and are often not based on real-time insights. In essence, these limitations have prevented us from maximizing the full network effects of our pharmacy business end-to-end across the enterprise. This challenge is precisely what brought us to Palantir. As we assessed the possible use cases to focus on, we knew that under any scenario, we needed at the foundation an industry-grade solution to more fully optimize the sum total of our pharmacy assets, capabilities, people, and investments. So we started by building out an ontology that serves as a digital twin of our complex operations. We integrated our data assets, models, and transactional systems within the ontology, roughly about 25 in less than 45 days, involving literally petabytes of data being fed in. Fast forward ahead, this foundation has enabled us to produce real-time insights, intelligent routing, and dynamic decision-making, which in turn is allowing us to maximize customer care along with business and operational performance. Taking it to the next step, building the ontology provided line of sight to supply and demand imbalances within our workflow. We always wanted to make sure that the right work was being completed in the right location by the right individual at the right time. And considering we have different role types between pharmacists and pharmacy technicians, there was some complexity we needed to manage through. We knew that doing so would not only maximize our productivity, but also optimize the care for our patients. So we started with a goal of piloting 10 stores within about 6 months. However, leveraging Foundry and AIP, we began to see real promise quickly in composing AI-powered end-to-end workflows that allowed us to get to about 4,000 stores within 8 months. Let me briefly walk you through how this all works within one of our use cases. So this map details the real-time view of 4,000 stores currently supported. We track through our systems the inflow and outflow of pharmacy tasks in 15-minute intervals. This provides visibility that we actually never had before centrally, and meant that we could route work to centralized staff members who could execute pharmacy tasks on behalf of our stores. In practice, our store teams have gotten really, really good over time at managing their workflow based on some general heuristics and tried and true patterns. However, we needed a tech-enabled and data-based solution that would allow us to be way better. So we applied new logic to real-time data feeds that could determine whether or not the store would benefit from centralized support. These could then run in the background and assign the right level of support, if any, at a given time based on real-time activity, staffing levels, and other store attributes and performance indicators. The tool would bring forward recommendations that users could then choose to approve or dismiss with the click of a button. You also can start to see what to expect over the course of a day for a store based on the level of support in anticipation of forecasted volume relative to historical actuals and staffing levels. Providing this central console was important for us to gain traction and provide safety in the earlier stages of our implementation and rollout. Clearly, however, it would be too burdensome to have individuals monitoring these views at all hours of every day, which meant we needed to start scaling and building out autonomous orchestration. If we were to rely on humans solely to accept or reject these suggestions every 15 minutes across 4,000 stores that are already rolled out, that would amount to about 384 billion decisions every day. And what you see in the diagram and the scale that we operate, it would be flat out impossible. So we've created a Kanban-style view that, as you see on the screen, shows the flow that would start automated actioning and would simulate and then apply set thresholds to load balance across the network. Piloting and scaling the solution was relatively easy, and we actually gained greater confidence in the integrity of the algorithms that went along with it. Thankfully, we had many problem statements and hypotheses that allowed us to test, learn, and iterate in an effort to continuously improve our effectiveness and efficiency. So while surely the automated solution gives us the greatest level of benefit, we also needed the ability and the requirement to manually override these decisions and create new ones. For example, a month ago during the catastrophic flooding in Kentucky, we used our load balancing solution to immediately activate support for all of our Kentucky stores, many of which were short-staffed due to damage in the surrounding areas. Through the click of a button, we were able to assign this routing immediately and seamlessly into our solution, which would then offload work from the stores and give us the best chance possible to fill our patients' prescriptions as quickly as possible. Before developing this load balancing solution, we never had the visibility or capability to unlock our data and make targeted decisions like we can now. We're finally able to integrate our inputs across the enterprise to optimally support all our team members and tangibly impact our patient experience. And as you saw from the demo, we gradually progressed, yet with pace. We started with real-time visibility and ensuring data integrity. We progressed to a recommendations engine for human evaluation, and have since advanced to more automated flows while still retaining the ability to manually adjust as appropriate. We've ultimately started to really transform our operating model. Workload balancing is something that had been envisioned for several years, had been piloted on a small scale. That's what we needed to help us advance and accelerate. So following this pilot, we have realized roughly about 30% of operational efficiencies from having rationalized and repurposed time and tasks so that our colleagues could focus on higher value activities and important patient services. In addition, we've expanded our use case to layer in when and how we deliver important clinical services to our patients, which has resulted in a 32% increase in patient engagement and pull-through to date. And we're just getting started. Having these capabilities at the center of our tech stack allows us to provide the best service with superior operational effectiveness and efficiency. And we're now looking at additional customer-facing optimizations and back-office business processes to advance. We are still very early in the journey, but this has proven to be impactful relatively quickly and truly allows us to understand all the working components of our business simultaneously with greater intelligence, dynamic decision-making, and continuous optimization. These use cases and advanced tooling are also beneficial for our employees. The product managers on my team, plus all the Walgreens engineers, data scientists, operators, and P&L leads that we work with, who are aiming to support our stores every day more effectively. I want to thank you very much for your time today. I hope you all have a great day.